you take a look at this fishing line, it's 4/100ths of an inch. And WashDOT says this is about the width of the largest crack. Now, engineers say that's not enough of a concern to shut down the viaduct completely, but they say they do have to close it again to be sure next week.
Just a couple weeks ago, WashDOT told city councilors that the Alaskan Way Viaduct was settling, close to half an inch in some places. They said they would get more information during their regularly scheduled inspection, but during that March 1st inspection, it wasn't settling they found, it was cracks.
They're very similar to what we've seen before. The concern is seeing new ones at this location and seeing some of the existing ones widen.
We're not sure exactly why the cracks have formed. We know it is some stresses on the structure, but we do know it's not related to the tunnel, as those tunnel activities are a half a mile south of here.
There's a lot of ivy on the viaduct near Seneca and Spring where the cracks were found. Crews couldn't remove it during that first inspection, so they're going to do that this week, then close the viaduct again on Saturday, March 22nd. They say at that time they can get better measurements of the cracks and put in some more monitors.
You know, this is a 60-year-old structure. It's in constant need of repair and attention to make sure we stay, keep it in service and make sure that it's safe.
WashDOT wants to assure everyone that the viaduct is safe for traffic now, and they should be able to repair cracks with an epoxy injection to keep it that way. But they still say the long-term solution is to finish the tunnel so the viaduct can be taken down in a few years.
With the repair work we do and with the monitoring we're doing, it should be more than enough to get us to the end of the project.
That is, of course, if the tunneling continues. The project was halted in early December, and it could be months before repairs to the boring machine Bertha are complete. City Councilman Mike O'Brien says that is a concern. That's why he and other council members have sent WashDOT a letter asking for more detailed information about the viaduct.
I just look forward to having a robust public discussion about how safe is safe enough, and how is the public insured, and how am I assured as a council member that the right people are keeping an eye on the right things.
The city council is giving WashDOT until the end of the month to answer all their safety questions. Again, WashDOT will be closing the viaduct on Saturday, March 22nd. That's just for more inspections. They could have to schedule another closure to actually do the repairs, but right now they think they'll be able to do that over a series of nights, so they won't have to impact traffic too much. Reporting live in downtown Seattle, Tina Patel, Q13 Fox News.